Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my singular pleasure and privilege as Chancellor of the National Orders to announce the names of those South Africans and foreign nationals who will be awarded national orders at the investiture ceremony to be held on Saturday, the 28th of April 2018. National orders are the highest awards that a country bestows on our citizens and eminent persons coming from outside this country who have contributed to the advancement of democracy and who have made a significant impact on improving the lives of South Africans. The National Orders also recognize the contributions made by individuals who contributed to a non-racial, non-sexist, democratic, and prosperous South Africa, as envisaged in our Constitution. This is the 24th investiture ceremony since the inception of the new national order system, contributing towards unity, reconciliation, and nation building. President Cyril Ramaphosa will bestow two deserving recipients, the Order of Ikhamanga, the Order of the Baobab, the Order of Luthuli, and the Order of the Companions of O.R. Tambo. Starting with the Order of Ikhamanga, which recognizes South African citizens who have excelled in the fields of the arts, culture, literature, music, journalism, and sport. The order will be bestowed in bronze on the following: Miss Tracy Mackie, for her contribution to the field of journalism and exposing the evils of apartheid. She exposed the covering up of the manner of Steve Biko's death was reported and exposed those in the security branch who were involved. It will also be awarded to Ms. Elsa Mayer for her excellent contribution to the field of senior athletics. The Order of Ikhamanga in silver will be awarded to the following: Mr. Hashim Amla, whom you all know, batsman, one of the best batsmen in the world. Mr. Omar Bacha, Mr. Bacha, for his commitment to the preservation of our country's history through groundbreaking research and the collection of profiles of those who participated in the struggle. It will also be awarded to Mr. Eric Baloyi, who is a boxing trainer who has produced a number of high profile boxers in this country who have made it in international competitions. The order in silver will also be awarded to the late Mr. Johan Botha, a great opera singer who succumbed to cancer a few years ago and had an international profile performing outside the country as well as inside the country and contributing to the organization CANCER, which is an organization that fights for those who have all sorts of cancers. The order of Ikhamanga in silver will also be bestowed on Miss Lillian Dube. Many of you know her as a prolific actor, has been acting for a long time, very good in storytelling, and has also participated in raising women's health issues. The order will also be bestowed on Mr. Sipho Hotsticks Mabuse, who also needs no introduction because of his contribution to music. The order will also be bestowed on Miss Elana Meyer, as you all know, middle distance athletics runner who blitzed the world with her speed and her endurance in various athletic meets, including the Olympics. Mr. John Mutankana, for his contribution to the field of fine art. His work remains an inspiration to many budding and established artists. Mr. Mutlankana will receive the award posthumous. The late Tami Mnyele, a soldier, an activist, was also a cultural activist. His creative work and legacy and his witness is witness that oppression does not diminish one's talent. He did a lot of culture while he was still in exile. Regrettably, as you all know, he was assassinated by the apartheid regime. Advocate Nakedi Ribane, also a well-known actor, who went beyond acting and acquired a LLB degree and ultimately qualified as an advocate for her great contribution to the performing arts and literature in particular. Mr. John Smith. John Smith is also well known, rugby captain of a World Cup winning rugby team. He was previously captain of the Sharks and subsequently became captain of South Africa and took us to win the World Cup. Mr. Neil Tovey, also well known, a former AmaZulu and Kaizer Chiefs captain, subsequently became captain of Bafana Bafana 1996, where we won our only African Cup of Nations as a country. The Order of the Baobab recognizes South African citizens who have contributed to community service, business and economy, science, medicine, and technological innovation. The order in silver will be bestowed on three South Africans: Mr. Lot Ndlovu, posthumous, for his contribution to economic transformation in South Africa, one of the pioneers of black economic empowerment, as many of you would know. Secondly, the Order of the Baobab will be bestowed in silver to Mr. Nkosinathi Freddy Ndlovu, for his excellent contribution to the fight for the recognition of the rights of people with disabilities. Thirdly, Ms. Violet Siboni, also posthumous, you would recall that she was in the forefront of worker struggles in this country, rising to become the treasurer of COSATU, was tragically killed in a car crash a few years ago. Then we come to the Order of Luthuli. The Order of Luthuli recognizes South African citizens who have contributed to the struggle for democracy, nation building, building democracy and human rights, justice and peace, as well as conflict resolution. The order will be bestowed in bronze on two individuals, both posthumous. First, Mr. Ronald Benico, for his lifelong contribution to the fight for social justice and fighting the system that oppressed our people in this country. Secondly, to Ms. Sylvia Benjamin for her contribution to the fight for workers' rights, a well-known fighter against apartheid. She embraced the cause of the disenfranchised, particularly workers and women. The Order of Luthuli will be bestowed in silver to the following: Mr. Godfrey Kenneth Beck, posthumous, for his contribution to the fight for liberation and equal rights in South Africa. Secondly, Ms. Lillian Diedrichs, for his contribution to the fight for liberation of all South Africans, in particular women. Ms. Diedrichs is one of the leaders of the 1956 Women's March. Thirdly, Ms. Mary Fitzgerald, posthumous, again for her gallant fight against oppression. She is well known in the struggle against apartheid, and his legacy actually continues to live on in downtown Johannesburg. As you know, there is a Mary Fitzgerald Square there. Professor Farid Isaac, Maulana Isaac, a brilliant activist against apartheid, a brilliant activist for democracy now, a great scholar currently teaching at the University of Johannesburg. He was one of those who led marches together with the other members of the religious community in the 1980s, even though those had been banned by the apartheid regime. Swami Karupa Gowden, an old activist from Durban, who again distinguished himself in the fight against apartheid, an old member of the then Natal Indian Congress, who taught many a young person the theory and practice of struggle during the darkest of days. The Reverend Charles Hooper, posthumous, again for his legendary fight against racism. He ultimately had to flee the country and passed away in exile. Ms. Bongile Mkabela, those of you who are familiar with the Nelson Mandela Children's Fund and the Children's Hospital would know Ms. Mkabela. She is the CEO of the Nelson Mandela Children's Fund, an activist of note and one of the leaders of the 1976 June 16 movement, who was greatly harassed and imprisoned by the apartheid regime, continues today to work for the cause of children. Hence, her being recognized in this role by none other than the late President Nelson Mandela. Major General Keith Mokwape, another one of the liberation veterans who went to faraway places to train as a soldier of liberation and fought against the evils of apartheid. The next is Ms. Rahima Musa, posthumous, one of the leaders of the 1956 Women's March here in the Union Buildings. Her name is indelibly inscribed in all our women's struggles in South Africa. General Moreti Mutau, for his contribution to the liberation movement and conflict resolution on the African continent. Many of you might know him previously as the Chief of Defense Intelligence. Mrs. Zondeni Veronica Sobukwe, for her great fight for freedom and her steadfast support of those of the freedom fighters who had been incarcerated, including her own husband. The Order of Luthuli in gold will be bestowed first on Chief, the late Chief Mhlabunzima Maphumulo of Table Mountain outside Pietermaritzburg, not the Table Mountain in Cape Town. There are many Table Mountains in South Africa. Chief Maphumulo raised the fight against the homeland system from earlier on and kept the flag flying in regard to the involvement of traditional leaders in the fight against apartheid. He was regrettably assassinated by agents of the apartheid regime in Pietermaritzburg a few years ago. Secondly, Justice Dikgang Moseneke will be awarded the Order of Luthuli in gold for his outstanding contribution in the field of law and the administration of justice in our country. A recently retired Deputy Chief Justice and himself a veteran of the liberation struggle who spent a number of years on Robben Island and came back to lead in the fight against apartheid and in the fight for justice and freedom. Thirdly, the Order of Luthulin Gold will be awarded posthumously to Mama Dora Damana, veteran leader of the South African Communist Party, veteran fighter for the rights of women, veteran fighter for the rights of workers. In the 1950s. Then we come to the order of the Companions of O.R. Tambo, which is the final order that will be bestowed by His Excellency President Ramaphosa. The Order of the Companions of O.R. Tambo recognizes eminent foreign nationals for friendship shown to South Africa. It is therefore an order of peace, cooperation, an active expression of solidarity and support to our country and people. The order will be bestowed in bronze on Miss Rosita Johnson from the United States for her contribution to the well-being of young South African exiles. When our people were in exile, Ms. Johnson used to go around the United States collecting books and equipment and sending these to various camps of the liberation movements, including to such establishments such as the Solomon Mahlangu Freedom College, SOMAFCO. The Order of the Companions of O.R. Tambo in silver will be awarded to Ambassador Alexander Jasokov, again for his contribution to the liberation movement for the people of South Africa and the people of Southern Africa in general, one of those who came from the old Soviet Union who fought in the trenches against the apartheid army that was infiltrating such countries as Angola, Namibia, Mozambique, Zimbabwe, Lesotho, as well as other countries on the front line. The order will again be installed on a man of a similar character as Ambassador Jasokov, and that is Mr. Vyacheslav Tetekin, also from the Soviet Union, a person who has fought in the trenches alongside various liberation movements in Southern Africa in general. The Order of the Companions of O.R. Tambo in gold will be bestowed on the following esteemed individuals: His Excellency Mr. Joaquim Chissano, former president of Mozambique, for his outstanding contribution to the liberation struggle in his country and in Southern Africa in general, and for his continued role in promoting peace on the African continent. The order will also be bestowed in gold posthumously on the late President of Botswana, His Excellency Sir Kitumile Khwetmasire, again for his exceptional contribution to the struggle for liberation in Southern Africa, particularly in South Africa, Mozambique and Zimbabwe and Namibia, as well as advancing the cause of peace on the African continent in countries such as Rwanda. The order will also be bestowed in gold on His Excellency Sam Nujoma, the founding president, founding father of Namibia, former president of the Southwest Africa People's Organization, SWAPO, a great fighter for freedom and liberation, who played a great role in fighting the apartheid government of the then racist South Africa, ultimately defeating it to become the father, founding father of Namibia, as well as paving the way for our own liberation in this country. Finally, the Order of the Companions of Oar Tambo will be bestowed on Her Excellency President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, recently retired President of Liberia, the first woman to be president on the African continent, for her exceptional contributions to women leadership and general leadership on the African continent, for her sterling role in conflict resolution in many volatile parts of the African continent. We congratulate all our recipients and urge South Africans to join us in celebrating these exceptional South Africans and distinguished friends of South Africa. I thank you.